What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. It's me, Mikey Pipes. Thursday, May 1st, 2025. Heading to my first service call of the day. We're going back to a customer that I was at on Monday morning. They had no cooling on the second floor system of this building. I went up to the air handler after checking for voltage at the thermostat. I only found 5 volts between R and Y, and R and G. There's only like 5 volts on the R wire at the thermostat, with the thermostat off, of course. And when I went up to the air handler, between L1 and ground, I had 110 volts. And between L2 and ground, I had 110 volts. But between L1 and L2, I did not have 240. So I referred the building owner to a licensed electrician. And apparently the electrician was there yesterday and said the unit is frozen and there's nothing wrong with the power. But he did replace a switch because it was missing one. Let's go see what's going on, guys. No voltage. Nothing. All right, so this is what I'm working with. This orange wire was on R. The pink wire was on RC. The white wire was on Y. The yellow wire was on W. And the green wire was on G. So G is fan. This, maybe there's a 2-transformer circuit here. There is, because there's a fan coil on the water heater coming from the boiler. This should be cooling and this should be heating, but this is cooling and that's heating. There's voltage on this wire, but nothing on here. Power switch here for light, even in a receptacle, which is nice. All right, let's make our way over there. I got some basic hand tools. I don't want to schlep up my tool bag up here unless I need to. Yeah, that's the kind of contractor installed this, left the old one just sitting here abandoned. Makes perfect sense. All right, and there's our new one. Let's go see what's going on. Well, there's a switch up here, which is in the off position. Let me turn that on. We have a rat's nest of wiring here. All right, I like to keep it simple. Let's take a look at the wiring coming out of our air handler. Red is 24 volts, brown is common, G is fan. If I take the red wire and put it to G, the blower should come on. All right. So the blower came on with R and G touched together. Okay. What that means is that I have 24 volts on R and I have a good blower motor. Now, these three wires with the blue not being used, this 4-conductor wire, that's got to be going to our thermostat. We'll trace that out in a second. The brown connects to a white, this 2-conductor wire, and that's going to be going to our outdoor condensing unit at the contactor. And this white wire, that's going to be the Y connection on the thermostat, which is for cooling. So when the thermostat's calling, 24 volts, which is on that red wire, is going to go to Y, and that's going to close the contactor. And common returns it to back to the ground. So let's follow this wire here. Can't believe I missed that. What the hell's going on here? Let me decipher this. All right, let's review what's going on here. I cleaned it up a little bit so you can get a better understanding. This brown wire right here, right, with the three conductors, the red, the white, and the green, that's coming from our air handler. Remember, the R is 24 volts. The white wire, right, they put on for common going to our outdoor contactor on the condensing unit, and the G is fan. Now, I traced out this wire here. That goes to our thermostat. So green and whatever this, I don't know where this is going, by the way. This other stuff, I have no idea where that's going. So the green, the white, and the red turns into pink. All right, maybe there's two thermostats. I don't know. I really don't know. The yellow, right, is white going to our boiler, and the orange is our red going to our boiler. This is R and W, or R, H, and W. So when there is a call for heat on the two transformer system, that R 24 volts is going to go close and close the W. Now, so we have pink is red, RC. The white is Y, G is G for fan. And the yellow wire is white and the orange is RH. You got it? Good luck. All right, we're back at the thermostat. And because I'm a creature habit of keeping things neat and clean, I removed all the extra garbage that was here and have my white wire, which we know is Y. The G is for, the green is for green for fan. The pink is RC. This is R, which is RH, and this is W. Let's hook that up to the terminals. First, let's actually check voltage here. Sorry. R and G, 32 volts. Crazy. All right, I'm back up in the attic. The outdoor unit is running. The indoor unit is running. My blower is running. I'm going to do an underload test for the, on the capacitor. Basically, what that means is we're going to test the capacitor while the blower is running. Okay, I'm using the HVAC school app right there. HVAC school app under tools. All right. So first thing we're going to do is we are going to take an amperage reading on that wire going to fan, the brown wire going to fan, dual capacitor. One wire is actually the wire and the other one is the power, but you know what, let's turn that off and let's discharge our capacitor with a pair of needle nose. Excellent. Let's pull off the two brown wires. Let's set our meter to read capacitance. And let's see what we get there. 5. I'm getting 5 on this 5 capacitor. So capacitor is good. All right, I have my JB probes hooked up. Here's my numbers. I got 11 degrees of subcooling. I have an indoor ambient temperature of 68 degrees now. My low side pressure, 83, high side, 217. You gonna tell me the electrician left the switch off for a reason? Everything else tests good. And in case you're wondering, return air was 71 degrees. My discharge coming out of my supply diffusers was an average of 48. 55 degrees outdoor ambient temperature. Not too shabby. Why the system froze up, why this wasn't working, I don't know. The contactor tested okay as well. Let me get your thoughts and feedback in the comment section down below. As always, thank you for supporting the channel. And don't forget to subscribe. There's no cost or obligation. And if you live in the Long Island, New York City metropolitan area, and you're tired of getting bamboozled by your HVAC contractor, I want you to pick up the phone and give me a call. 516-348-6300. Or save time. Book online at pipedoc.net. Thank you very much for watching. Catch you in the next one. Be well. God bless. Stay safe.